And then you got your $10. Oh, hey, Julia. Apparently, Julia thinks she's entitled to some time on stage, too. So I guess I'll turn it over here. Without further ado, the infamous online Obama composite character, Julia.
In a Head Start program to help get her ready for school. Because the steps that President Obama has taken to improve programs like this one, Julia joined thousands of students across the country who will start kindergarten ready to learn and succeed. Under President Obama, Julia takes the SAT and is on track to start her college application. Her high school is a part of the Race to the Top program implemented by President Obama. Their new college and career-ready standards mean Julia can take the classes she needs to do well. Also, under your illustrious President Obama, she prepares for her first semester of college. Julia and her family qualify for President Obama's Americans Opportunity Tax Credit, worth up to $10,000 for students who receive a Pell Grant to help put a college education within reach. And under President Obama, during college, Julia undergoes surgery. Thankfully covered by her insurance due to a provision in the health care reform that lets her stay on her parish cover until she's 26 years old. Under President Obama, because of steps like the Lilly Ledbetter Fair Pay Act, Julia is one of millions of women across the country who know she'll always be able to stand up for her right to equal pay. She'll start her career as a web designer. Also under President Obama, after graduation, Julia's federal student loans are more manageable since President Obama capped income-based federal student loan payments and kept interest rates low. She makes her payments on time every month, keeping her on track to pay her student loans. And under President Obama, for the past 4 years, Julia has worked full-time as a web designer. Thanks to Obamacare, her health insurance is required to cover her birth control and preventative care, letting Julia focus on her hard work rather than worry about her health. Under President Obama, Julia decides to have a child. Throughout her pregnancy, she benefits from maternal checkups, prenatal care, and free screening under her health care reform. Under President Obama, Julia's son Zachary starts kindergarten. The public school in their neighborhood has better facilities now and great teachers.
Dana Loesch, how are you? Okay, by the way, I don't wear hipster capris. I don't wear hipster flats. Give me my 4.5-inch stilettos. God bless America. Folks, we have 10 days. Can you believe that's how Democrats like their women? Faceless and voiceless. That's the war on women right there! But that's how they like it. For the past couple of days, I have been living in a war on women hell. We've had a story with Richard Murdoch in Indiana. We had Tom Aiken in my state of Missouri. Democrats are so eager to avoid running on their record that they're going to try. This is what they've been doing for the past, I don't know, here. They've been running around the country going, look, 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 rape, to all of the women all across the country. Scaring everyone. Those are the tactics that this party loves best. Scaring people with slavery. Scaring old people. people by saying we're going to throw you off a cliff in a wheelchair. And rape. Abortion. I wasn't alive during the 60s. But I thought that we had already gone through all of that. I'm a woman. There's no war on women against me. In fact, I find that I have it easier than a lot of men. To be quite honest with you, that's a war on women right there. Now, with Indiana and Missouri and everything else, let me ask this, a war on women, which presidential candidate, while he was a state legislator, which candidate was the one who was voting against increasing protections for rape victims? Which presidential candidate was it when he was a state legislator actually voted against sealing victims' records so that they wouldn't have to fear retribution or anything else if they went to trial? What Mitt Romney? Tell you that. That's a war on women. I'm so tired of hearing about this. I'm so tired of this gotcha crap. That's exactly what it is. They're just playing semantics. It's just a gotcha game. I'm tired of it. Here we have, on the heels of learning what happened in Benghazi, right on the heels of learning that someone lied and people died, all we're hearing about is rape and abortion and birth control. That's all we're hearing about. As a side note, I said I was going to dress up as Jim Messina for Halloween and get a big van and write free birth control on the side of it. That's pretty scary, isn't it? This war on women doesn't exist. There's no pay inequality. There is no pay inequality. That's a lie. They're lying to you. You know the pay inequality that's happening that we're seeing now? Is with men. Men are starting to earn less. Men are starting to get promoted less. They did a study where they looked at 9 major cities across the country. Miami, New York, they even looked at Chicago. And what did they find? Women are being promoted. Women are starting to make more money than men. Because women, it's a commodity. Democrats promise them things they don't fulfill. And then afterwards, here look, we have the destruction of the American family and so on and so forth. Women apparently don't care about the economy. We don't care about health care. We don't care about anything else except free contraception. That is such an insult. I'm so tired of hearing people say, well, we need to talk about women's issues. Jobs and how much money I have in my bank account and my ability to go to the grocery store and afford food for a week, that's a woman's issue as well. I want to thank FreedomWorks, by the way, because I don't know anybody else who would have said, that sounds great, when one of their speakers asked if they could come on stage in a nude bodysuit. So I want to thank them for that. Now, it's a distraction. The Health and Human Services Board, the death panels, as they called it. In my state, my senator, the Democrat incumbent, was the 60th vote for Obamacare. And she likes to go around the state and try to and scare everybody by saying that Republicans, conservatives, patriots, that they want to control women's choices when it comes to their health care. And I had to think about that because I remember just a year and a half ago. Do you remember that controversy that erupted when this Kathleen Sebelius appointed HHS board, unelected, not a single oncologist on the board? When they decided to tell women under age 40 and under, you don't need to get breast health exams. You don't need to get mammograms. Women don't get breast cancer at that age. I would love for them to tell my 37-year-old cousin that, because she survived it. I would love for Kathleen Sebelius to look at all of the women that I see at all of the different charitable events around the country for breast cancer awareness, survivors, and I want for them to tell these women, you don't need to get that because you're not supposed to get this. You're not supposed to get breast cancer when you're under 40. But they do anyway. That was actually one of the first steps that HHS was making as a cost control measure. That's a war on women. taking education away from our local communities, federalizing it in Washington, D.C., that's also a war on women. A war on mothers and fathers. Occupy type stuff. One path is believing that government is your be-all, end-all. That government can provide for you, it can take care of you, and in exchange, it just wants a little bit of your freedom. We have some very esteemed members of our audience that know better than that. That's not a trade-off. The other pathway is to go back to a country that more resembles what the Founding Fathers intended. Self-sustainability, true independence. And that's the choice that we have coming in November. I'm tired of this war on women from Democrats, so much so that they're about to get a war from women this November. I'm done with it. I'm so excited, and when the results come in, and when we are victorious in November, there's your war from women, there's your war from men, there's your war from the teenagers, there's your war from the kids, there's your war from the American family. We're fed up, we're done with your ooby boogie boogie fear mongering, we've had enough.